Hey everyone, welcome in. Thank you for joining me. So interestingly, I picked up a new deck of cards this afternoon and I just did a short with it, but I wanted to go into these three cards a little bit more. I wanted to actually bring the book forth because the messages are very powerful. And so I wanted to show you again these cards and then the message that comes through. The cards are called Angels and Ancestors, and this is by Kyle Gray, these cards. The first thing that comes up, the first card, is the Shield Maiden. And it encourages you to make plans and focus, right? So have strategy. So the message is have a plan or a strategy in place before moving forward. The Shield Maiden is a female knight in shining armor. In Viking traditions, women were seen as equal to men, and so joined them on their raids and fought with them on the battlefield. In this deck, the Shield Maiden brings a fiercely feminine energy, the power to be a warrior while retaining feminine sensitivity. She is ready to put her plan into action. She's ready to go into battle. Her medicine helps us move beyond any unsettled feelings when our plans start to take shape and follow through with our strategies in order to be where we want to be. Shield maidens work together in times gone by to create shield walls of protection. So she also shows us how to work with others in order to bring our plans to fruition. The extended message here, and I'm getting goosebumps and I haven't even read it yet. It says, take some time to assess what your next steps will be. All great warriors have a plan. You are a sensitive being, and if you are not prepared for the tasks you are taking on, you could end up feeling exposed and helpless. The ancestor guidance that is coming to you now is a reminder that you have a warrior's heart and that you have it within you to be more prepared and focused than you have been recently. So have a strategy in place and then let your guide support you as you move forward. Okay. So the next card here is the Wise One, and it says grow within your current situation, right? So what is it that you have been going through and or experiencing? Okay, so let's just tap into this one. And it says, the message is that knuckle down, be reliable and committed. Be open to wisdom and insights from your elders. The Wise One represents the wisest aspect of the goddess, the crone. In paganism and modern Wicca, the crone is the fiercest, most psychic, and most aware aspect of the goddess because she has been through many of life's challenges and overcome many setbacks. On this card, the raven in her hands represents the capacity to overcome the darker times and to be reborn again and again. So she helps you to tap into wisdom to overcome whatever life throws at you. Wisdom being the transformation stored in your soul rather than the knowledge acquired in this lifetime, and to learn from the experience of your elders. The extended messages here: the wisdom of the Wise One is based on something that the younger generation is often lacking, commitment and reliability. When this card appears, you are being guided to continue working on your growth and expansion within your current situation. Be committed to your tasks and projects. It can be very easy to get bored or overwhelmed, but persevere. You are being reminded of how it feels to be let down and experience unreliability, and that it is not who you were born to be. So keep working on what you're working on, because it is going to be extremely beneficial for you in the long run. So this is like, now just even as I'm thinking about this again, how many times do we kind of run away from a situation that's making us uncomfortable? We just want to avoid it, get away from it, right? It could be because there's things going on in our home, so we try to avoid a situation. It could be something that's going on in your place of employment or in a relationship with, you know, whatever, a spouse, partner, whatever, or a friendship, something like that, right? So we create this space. And oftentimes, you know, very interesting, because the next card speaks on creating or holding space for a situation, okay? So this is encouraging you to, you could still be working on your plan and growing, right? Creating a strategy. You can still be working on that as you continue to grow in your current situation and whatever is going on. But here, the next one is the Druid. And the card says, hold the space, right? So the Druid card, this is very interesting. One moment, I think I just missed a page. Maybe I didn't miss it. There's three categories here on these cards, so one moment. The Druid, the message for the Druid says, hold things together. Now, very interesting, right? So if you are in a situation and you're wanting to go, right, that like kind of run away from it, tap dance around it, do everything you can, but move through it, right? Right now you're being encouraged to hold it together. Don't make any sudden moves or changes, but that doesn't mean that you can't still plan and have a strategy, right? Stand strong, knowing you are where you are supposed to be. The Druids were the ancient wise ones of the British Isles. They had deep connection with the earth, the sun, and the moon. They were the scholars who created the Ogham Tree language, and they were known for their creative skills in storytelling, poetry, and craftsmanship. The extended message is, when the Druid card appears in a reading, you are being guided to dig deep within and to hold your station. If you are wondering what to do next or have a sense of anxiety about what is unfolding in your life, it is time to shift your perceptions and move back to a state of trust. Don't change your plans or do anything drastic. Just trust the process and let everything happen as it needs to before taking any more steps. Think of a tree. It has strong roots yet continues to grow and bear fruit. Your life will be a reflection of this, right? This is coming to me as, how many times do we have admiration for those who have been that steady force, either in our life or we've maybe noticed it in another's life, right? That steady fort, that anchor that kind of just holds strong, right? And so that is what you are being encouraged to do. I say not only holding space for yourself and what it is that you are moving through, but hold space for others in relationship to what you are experiencing, because they too have their own journey, right? And sometimes people, they won't ask for space, right? But we can certainly recognize that maybe they're going through something, right? They're going through it. They're not dancing around it, right? So they're going through it. They're moving through it. And we can see it if we are perceptive, right? And we are aware of what's going on around us, within us, and with others, right? So holding space for others can look like simply being around when someone's going through something, not always trying to be a fixer, not trying to fix their problems, their situations, or fix them. Allowing them to move through the journey as they need to move through. I'm kind of getting the image of just, you know, very quietly, like, holding the head just slightly here, right? Not down, but just slightly, like with the eyes just gently closed, and allowing them to sense that you are not a threat, even though they are going through something. And actually, it's reminding me of I watched a video last night, and this guy goes to pet shelters, and there was a dog that obviously had been mistreated, right? Because it was just, you know, you could just tell in the dog's demeanor. Anyway, so the guy went in there and he sat there, and you could tell the dog was getting anxious, and he wasn't reaching out to him, he just sat there. But when he finally actually turned his back to the dog, then pretty soon the dog started to warm up to him. But it wasn't because he wasn't getting in his face, he wasn't looking in his face, he was holding space for that dog, right? To kind of move through its challenges and to kind of come around, right? So it's an excellent example of when someone's going through something. The other thing I'm thinking about is, like, say for instance, when a child is having like a temper tantrum, right? Oftentimes you'll see parents just hold them and let them have that and just kind of exert that energy out of their body and let them know it's okay for you to express yourself, but you are safe. But I want to say thank you for joining me. I hope you have an amazing day. Take care.